Jesus, I thank you so much.
In the name of Jesus Christ, I speak.
So then, I thank you so much. I thank you for my Pantia.
Thank God that our brothers and sisters can come here to partake of this Holy Communion
sacrament.
Before we consecrate the bread and the grape juice, our brethren learn some teaching concerning Holy Communion.
我们知道说在这个教会里头有三大圣。
We know in the Trinity Church there are three sacraments.
我们的圣体跟一般基督教里头含的圣是不一样的。
The sacraments that we talk about are different from the sacraments in other churches.
我们知道说真耶稣教会的圣体呢是耶稣亲自所设立的。
We know that the sacraments in the Trinity Church are personally established by our Lord Jesus.
We
have three sacraments.
For
example, baptism. Before Jesus ascended, he directed, commanded the apostles to carry out this.
但是他在世的时候呢，他自己已经设立了一个很好的榜样。
But whilst Jesus was still in the world, he already gave a good example.
当他吩咐门徒的时候，他说：“信了受洗的必然得救。”
After he had commanded the disciples, he said, "Those who believe and baptize shall be saved."
所以这个圣礼是跟得救有关系的。
So therefore, sacraments are related to our salvation.
我们如果看这个洗脚礼，
if we look at foot washing.
主耶稣亲自设立的洗脚礼，
Lord Jesus personally instituted foot washing.
那洗脚礼跟得救是有关系的。
So foot washing is related to our salvation.
所以主耶稣才说，我若不洗你的脚，就跟我无关。
So Jesus says, if I do not wash your feet, you have no part in me.
过后，主耶稣吩咐门徒要照着去做。
Then the Lord Jesus instructed his disciples to do likewise.
圣餐礼呢也是一样。
Same for the Holy Communion.
我们领受圣餐的时候，
when we receive the Holy Communion,
就是领受主耶稣的生命。
We are receiving the life of our Lord Jesus.
我们就有将来的这个复活的盼望。
And we have the hope of a future resurrection.
这是跟得救有关系的。
This is related to so these sacraments are personally instituted by our Lord Jesus. On the night that he was, day that he was betrayed, he established Holy Communion. And he also instructed the disciples to conduct Holy Communion regularly. Even that this sacrament is somewhat different to the other two. Because for baptism, we only receive the true baptism once. Except for foot washing. But for the Holy Communion, we need to keep this, observe this regularly. Of course, there is a main reason. This is to remember the death of the Lord. The main difference between the sacraments of the Trinity Church and other churches is that we have the abundance of the Holy Spirit. When we are conducting a water baptism, we believe that the blood of Christ is in the water. Because it has the abundance of the Holy Spirit. When we wash feet of others.
我们知道说这个接受洗脚礼的人一定会跟主有份。
We believe that this person who receives foot washing will have a part with Jesus.
因为有圣灵在动工。
Because the Spirit is working.
我们也知道说，当我们赐主耶稣的这个身体跟喝他的血的时候
，eat the body and the blood of Christ.
我们里头会有他的生命。
And we will have a life within.
因为有圣灵跟我们同在。
Because the Holy Spirit is with us.
因为有圣灵的同在，注谢的时候，这个饼就是主耶稣的身体。
Because of the abundance of the Holy Spirit, after consecration, the bread becomes the body of Christ.
那这个葡萄汁就是主的宝血。
The grape juice is the blood of Christ.
因为有圣灵的同在。
Because of the abundance of the Holy Spirit.
我们现在来谈一些有关圣餐礼的教训。
Now we share a few teachings regarding the Holy Communion.
我们先来看这个哥林多前书的第十一章。
Let's turn to 1 Corinthians chapter 11.
哥林多前书的第十一章，我们来念二十四节跟二十五节。
First Corinthians chapter 11:24-25。
二十四节。
24。
祝谢的就拨开说：“这是我的身体，为你们舍的，你们应当如此行，为的是纪念我。
”And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said.Take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me.
25. 班众也照样拿一杯来说，这杯是用我的血所立的新约。你们每逢喝的时候要如此行，为的是纪念我。
In the same manner, he also took the cup after supper, saying, This cup is the new covenant in my blood.Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me.
圣经教导我们，我们每逢在吃圣餐的时候，为的是要纪念主耶稣的死。
The Bible tells us that as often as we conduct the Holy Communion, we remember the death of the Lord.
那我们要怎么去纪念
？How do we remember?
这是一个关键的问题，也值得我们去思考的。
This is an important question that we need to understand.
如果我们没有纪念的话，那就是说圣餐礼嘛。很多时候我们在吃主耶稣的肉、喝主耶稣的时候，的血的时候，却没有真正了解它的意义是什么。
If we don't understand what it means to remember, then we are not truly every time we partake of the blood and eat the body.I'm not truly understood meaning.
先来讲一个简单的一个想法。
Just to share a very simple concept.
圣经说我们要听神的话。
The Bible says we need to listen to the word of God.
我们每天都在听。
We listen every day.
但我们有没有真正的听？
Are we truly listening?
那圣经是怎么定义的？
How does the Bible define it?
一个真正听的人，
Somebody who truly listens,
就是听了之后他会接受神的道。
After he has listened, he will receive the word of God.
然后你看到说这个道在他心中就会产生很大的一个作用。
He will accept the word of God, and the word of God will become a greatstrength within him.
让这个人呢变成一个非常我们说属灵的人。
So that this person will become a very spiritual person.
因为他会遵照神的话来去行。
Because he knows how to put into practice the word of God.
这叫听。
This is what it means to listen.
那我们说如果是纪念的话。
Now when we talk about to bring to remembrance.
主耶稣在2000年前就替我们死了。
Lord Jesus died for us 2,000 years ago.
我们要纪念他的死。
We need to remember his death.
就是说主耶稣这个替我们死的一件事情一定会影响到我们的生命。
Which means that the death that Jesus died for us is definitely to affect our spiritual life.
我们现在的生活一定会被主耶稣的死来影响。
The life that we live today should be affected influenced by the death of Jesus.
好，我们现在就从圣经来看几个例子，来做个说明。
We'll look at an example in the Bible.
我们先来看哥林多前书的第二章。
First Corinthians chapter 2.
我们念哥林多前书的第二章。
First Corinthians chapter 2.
我们来念这个第二节。
Verse 2.
哥林多前书二章二节
First Corinthians chapter 2 verse 2
因为我曾定的旨意在你们中间不知道别的只知道耶稣基督并他钉十字架
For I determined not to know anything among you except Jesus Christ and him crucified、
那保罗写信给哥林多教会的时候
When Paul wrote a letter to
他告诉他们呢、他什么都不想知道听起来看起来好像是这样他只知道耶稣被钉十字架
Seems that all he wants to know among them is that Jesus was crucified
我们知道说当时教会有纷争
You know at the time that there was division in the church
那这个纷争呢造成教会很大的伤害
We know that this division creates a lot of damage in the church.
我们知道说主耶稣替我们死在十字架上。
We know that our Lord Jesus died for us on the cross.
根据保罗的教导。
According to the teaching of.
他死在十字架上就灭了烟尘。
After he died on the cross, he destroyed the enmity.
那相信的人。
And those who believe.
你发现说这些人跟神之间的这些隔墙啊，都被除去了。
That those are the wall of separation has been removed.
那人与人之间的隔墙也同时被除去了。
Between God is removed and also between human beings.
所以保罗说，就让我们进入到神的身体。
That's why Paul says that it allows us to enter into the body of Christ.
我们来看以弗所书的第二章。
Let's look at Ephesians chapter 4.
第二章。
Sorry, chapter 2.
我们来念这个十六节。
Ephesians chapter 2, verse 16.
第二章的十六节。
Ephesians chapter 2, verse 16.
你在十字架上灭了烟头，便是借这十字架使两项归为一体。这一体就是弯玻璃以神和好了。
And the 16, and that he might reconcile both to God in one body, those body through the cross, therefore putting to death the enmity.
我们知道说主耶稣死在十字架上。
When Jesus died on the cross,
他不单只赦免我们的罪。
Not only did he forgive us our sins,
同时也让我们进入到他里面。
He allowed us to enter into Him.
所以保罗说这就成为一体了。
So that's why Paul says that we become one body.
让我们能够在他的身体来被建造。
So that we can be built up in His body.
我们知道说这就是神的教会。
We know that this is the Church of God.
我们在看哥林多前书的时候。
Back to First Corinthians.
因为当时教会有纷争。
Because there was division at that time.
那就是说他们忘记了主耶稣在十字架上所为他们成就的事情。
It means that they had forgotten the work of Jesus' salvation on the cross.
他忘记了主耶稣的死。
They had forgotten the death of Christ.
借着主耶稣的死，这个烟囱被毁掉。
They had forgotten that through the death of Christ, the enmity has been destroyed. So Paul wrote to them. But I only want to know, I do not want to know anything else except Jesus crucified on the cross.
就是要让他们重新再去思想主为他们的牺牲。
That is, he wants them to once again remember the sacrifice of Jesus for them.
就是说，虽然他们有在吃圣餐
，In other words, even though they are partaking of the Holy Communion,
但是这个圣餐看起来好像产生不出那个应有的功效。
It seems that the partaking of the Holy Communion does not produce the desired effect.
那就是说，他们没有真的去纪念主耶稣的死。
which means that they are not truly remembering the death of Christ.
我们纪念主耶稣的死不是坐在这里听道理，就是纪念主耶稣的死。
This remembering the death of Christ is not just coming here to sit and listen to sermons.
这是需要的。
This is necessary.
但更重要的，我们要让这件事情来影响我们的生命。
More importantly, we need to allow this to affect our life.
有时候在家庭里头有纷争。
Often in our families, there can be divisions.
在教会里头也有纷争。
In the church, there are divisions.
那这告诉我们什么？
What does this tell us?
我们没有真正纪念主耶稣的死。
It means that we are not truly remembered the death of Christ.
如果真正纪念的，就是说被这件事情来影响。
If we truly remember, that means that we have become affected by this matter.
这纷争就不会存在。
Then division will no longer exist.
因为耶稣在十字架把烟从灭了。
Because Jesus has destroyed the enmity.
借他的死让我们跟神和好。Through
his death, he has reconciled us to God.
如果是这样的话，
if this is the case,
那为什么还有纷争？
Why is there still division?
那就是说我们没有好好去思考、思想这件事情。
It means that we have not truly meditated all about this matter.
保罗在讲这件事情的时候，他是提醒教会，我什么都不要知道。
So when Paul said to this to the church, he said, I don't want to know anything else.
那我们所要知道的就是。 主耶稣跟他的牺牲。
What I want to know from you is concerning the sacrifice of Christ.
我们讲难听一点，有时候我们是把自己的意念放在神的意念之上。
Very often we put our own will, desire above the desire of God.
我们没有顺着神的旨意来行。
We are not walking according to the will of God.
所以才会产生很多的问题。
That's why we create so many problems.
那主耶稣的牺牲，
the sacrifice of our Lord Jesus,
告诉我们说，他没有自己的意见，他纯粹是为了要来成全天父的这个旨意。
Tells us that he does not have his own will. Everything he did was to accomplish the will of the Father.
所以我们在教会里头也应该是这样。
So today is the same in the church.
其实人的意见不算个什么。
The opinion of man does not count for much.
我们所要关注的就是神的旨意。What
we need to hold on to is the will of God.
在教会里头，我们有没有尽心尽力把神的旨意行出来？
Do we practice the will of God with all our heart and all our strength?
那才是重要的。That
is what's most important.
我们如果常常这样做的，
if we do this often,
那就是说我们对主耶稣的这个牺牲非常的清楚。
Means that we are very clear about the sacrifice of the Lord Jesus.
我们这样做的话，我们才会被主耶稣的爱来感动。
Only in this way can we be touched by the love of Christ.
我们才能这样想。
We ought to think.
那如果我们真的明白主的爱，
if we truly understand the love of our Lord Jesus.
如果你明白一个人的爱，你一定会感动。
If you understand the person's love for you, you will be very moved.
你一定会想到他的爱。
You will certainly think about his love.
那其他的事情你不会去想太多。
You will not think too much about other things.
同样的，我们如果真的被神的爱来感动，
similarly, if we are moved by the love of God,
你一定会去思想神的爱。
You will contemplate the love of God.
在思想当中，你看到说人与人之间的这些误解啊什么， 得罪的事情都会什么消失掉。
Whilst we are contemplating thinking about the love of God and all the misunderstandings, all the frictions and the problems that you have with other people will be diminished.
那如果人常常有这种争斗的心态，
if we always have this heart of wanting to fight,
那就是说我们对主耶稣的爱一点都不清楚。
That means that we are not clear at all about the love of Christ.
我们可以说我们根本就没有纪念主耶稣的死。
You can say that basically we don't remember the death of Christ.
因为主耶稣的爱会把我们这些所谓的仇恨都融化掉。
Because the love of Christ is supposed to melt away all the hatred that are.
为什么我们信主信这么久，还是以这样的一种心态？
Why is it that we believe in Christ for so long, yet we still have this way of thinking?
还是常常敌对的。
Still fighting against others.
还是不能够相处，好好的相处。
Not able to get along well with one another.
所以我们就想，我们是怎么来纪念主耶稣的死。
We need to think, how do we remember the death of Christ?
我们来看第二个例子。
Look at the second example.
们看加拉太书，我们看加拉太书的第二章。
Galatians chapter two。
我们从十八节开始看。
You read from verse 18。
加拉太书第二章的这个十八节。
Galatians chapter two verse 18。
我素来所拆毁的，若重新建造，这就是证明自己是犯罪的人。
For if I build again those things which I destroy, I make myself a transgressor.
十九节。
19.
我因律法就像律法死了，叫我可以向神活着。
For I through the law died to the law that I might live to God.
二十节。我已经与基督同钉十字架，现在活着的不再是我，乃是基督在我里面活着，并且我如今在肉身活着，是因信神的儿子而活，他是爱我，为我舍己。
The 20. I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God.He loved me and gave himself for me.
在当时的使徒教会发生了一个问题。
In the apostolic church, there was a problem.
有些人呢，他们传讲说要回归律法，把耶稣放进去。
There were some people that were preaching that we need to return to the law, Mosaic law, and put Jesus aside.
那就是说他们要靠律法来称义，就是说不用靠耶稣，靠律法。
Or they want to rely on the law to be righteous.
我们知道说保罗是一个懂律法的人。
You know that Paul is somebody who knew well the law.
对摩西的律法非常的清楚。
He's very clear about the law of Moses.
但他信了耶稣之后
But after he believed in Jesus,
他被改造过来的。
He became a changed person.
他不相信说靠律法可以得救。
He did not believe that you can be savedby relying on the law.
所以在十八节他才说他把这些都拆毁了。
So he says in verse 18 that he has destroyed these things.
他不会再重新建造这样的一个观念。
He will not once again build up this kind of concept.
因为主耶稣的死让他明白这一点。
Because the death of Christ allows him to understand this point.
没有借着主耶稣的死，主耶稣的牺牲，没有人能够得救。
Without the death of Christ, the sacrifice of Christ, he is not only able to be saved.
所以他才说主是爱他的。
So that's why he says that the Lord loves him.
为他而死
，died for him.
我们今天可能不会经历这样的一件事情。
Maybe we have not undergone this.
但是我们要想说，我们在平时的生活当中。我们所建造的是什么？
We need to think about our daily life and what do we build?
我们在家庭里头做了每件事情。
In our homes, our family, the things that we do.
我们其实都是在建造。
We are building things.
那就好像我们说我们要建立自己的家。
You say we want to build up our homes.
要怎么建造？
How do you build it?
我们说家不是光光是讲一个房子而已。
Building is not just the home, is not just talking about the physical building.
我们谈到家的时候，就是说我们家里的成员。
When we talk about the home, we're talking about the people.
那我们要怎么建立这家？
How do we build up this house?
我们如果在家里头是常常祷告的。
If we pray often at home,
我们留下好榜样。
We need to set a good example.
其实这就是一种的建造。
This is a way of building.
然后因为小孩看见的。
Because the children can see.
那个父母都很专注于祷告。
That the parents are very focused on pray.
凡事祷告。
They pray in all things.
他们就学会。
The children will also learn well.
那如果在家里头
if in the church,
我们所谈论的是彼此相爱的事情。
We talk about things about how to love one another.
我们就营造出一种非常好的气氛。
So we will create a very good environment.
那进来的人呢，一定会感受到。
And those who join will also be can experience this.
所以外面进来的人呢，一定会感受到说这个家庭不一样。
And those who are outside and visit our homes, they can see and feel that this house is different.
他们知道说这是属神的家。
This home is different in the eyes of God.
我们今天在建造怎么样的家？
So today, what kind of home are we building?
昨天在我们参加教会。
Similarly, when we come to church,
这是主耶稣的身体。
This is the blood of Christ.
我们常说，我们要在原有的基础上来建造。
This is the body of Christ, and we need to build up on the foundation.
我们在建造怎么样的一个教会
？Now, what kind of church are we building?
如果有机会哈，你可以去探访每个不同的教会。
If you have the opportunity to go and visit different churches,
那你听弟兄姐妹的谈话，你跟他们交通。
When you listen to the conversations of the members and you speak to them,
你就会知道说他们所看重的是什么。
And you will be able to observe what they place their emphasis.
我们感谢神，我们现在教会的弟兄姐妹对于属灵的追求，非常的用心。
We thank God that our sisters they do put in their efforts to pursue after the things of God.
那其实主耶稣死了。借着他的死，我们才有教会。
It is only because of the death of Christ that we have the church.
如果我们所看重的是教会的建造，就是说有属灵的这个品质在里头。
If we see and emphasize on the building up of the church based on the spiritual criteria,
那我们可以说我们对主耶稣的牺牲，是有相当的认识。
And that means when we do understand the death of Christ,
我们也是纪念主耶稣的死。
And we remember the death of Christ.
我们纪念一个人，不单只是这个人本身，我们也会纪念他所做过的事情。
When we remember a person, we don't just remember that person himself, but also the things that he has done.
他所讲过的话。
The things that he has said,
我们都会记住
we will remember.
我们说我们纪念主耶稣的死
we say we remember the death of Christ.
同样的，我们要纪念他所做过的事情
Similarly, we need to remember the things that he has done.
保罗说就是灭掉烟愁
Paul says that he has destroyed the enmity.
所以在家庭里头，在教会里头，我们要尽力除掉烟愁。
So in the church, in our homes, we need to do our utmost best to remove the enmity.
这样我们所以说我们是纪念。
Only then can we say we truly remember.
当我们这样做的时候，我们才能够体会到神真正的爱。
When we are able to do this, then we can truly experience that God loves us.
因为保罗在建造的时候，他是在建造自己的教会。
Because when Paul was building, he was not building his own church.
他是照着神的吩咐、神的指示来去建造教会。
He was building the church according to the instruction of God.
那么我们在念加拉太书的时候，他是跟这些所谓的律法师来争辩。
When we're reading Galatians, Paul was debating with those who are know the law.
那当然也借着这个机会来提醒他们。
And he also took the opportunity to remind them.
这些事情在神家里头是不可以接纳的。
These things cannot be accepted in the house of God.
因为会让人离开耶稣。
Because they will cause a person to depart from Christ,
最终他会失去救恩。
In the end, they will lose their salvation.
所以保罗对这件事情非常的清楚。
So Paul is very clear on that.
所以他最后才能够说他是爱我，为我舍己的。
That's why he's able to say that he died, loved me, and he sacrificed for me.
我们能够感受到神的爱不是一时的冲动。
To experience the love of God is not a one-off emotional experience.
这个能够感受到是时常的事情。
to be able to experience should be a long-term thing.
我们能够感受到是因为我们在建造神教会，建造神教会。
We are only able to experience it if we are building the house of God.
真正是跟着他的旨意来去建造。
But we are truly building his church according to the will of God.
这样我们才能够体会到神。
Only then can we experience the love of God.
有的时候我们信主很久，但是没有感动。
Often we believe in Lord for a long time, but we are not moved.
所以在没有被主耶稣的爱感动的话，问题就会产生。
When we are not moved by the love of Christ, then all kinds of problems will occur.
有一些芝麻小事，我在为一些芝麻小事都可以吵的。
We can argue and fight over very trivial small matters.
因为心态没有改变。
Because our heart, the mentality has not changed.
在教会也是一样。
In the church, the same.
如果我们建造是神的家，照着他的旨意来去做的话
，build the church of God according to the will of God.
那一定我们就会感受到他。
We will definitely experience his love.
我们在建造教会的时候，应该有这样一个思想。
So we need to have this way of thinking when we are building the church.
耶稣在建造我们，让人能够归入他的时候呢，他是完全牺牲的。
Because when Jesus built the church for us to belong to him, he sacrificed his completely.
所以我们在建造教会的时候，也应该有这样一个心。
So when we are building the church, we should also have the same mentality.
很多时候我们应该这样想。
We should think like this.
只要教会被建立起来就好。
As long as the church is built up, that's good enough.
我的存在不重要。
My existence in the church is not important.
有时候我们把自己的存在看得太重要了。
Sometimes we place too much emphasis on our own importance.
把自己看得非常重要，高过神了。
On our own existence, we put our own existence higher than that of God.
所以你想说这是纪念主的死。
Now, is this remembering the death of Christ?
我们可能在圣餐礼的时候，我们有想主耶稣的死，但是在平时生活当中，没有办法把主耶稣的牺牲活出来。
Maybe in Holy Communion, during the sacrament, we think about the death of Christ, but in our everyday life, we don't think about it, and we are not able to put into practice this spirit of sacrifice.
我们希望说，这个国民的教会能够成为一个好像耶稣基督那种牺牲的教会。
We hope that the church in Birmingham is able to have the spirit of sacrifice of Jesus.
每个人都有这种愿意牺牲自己的心。
Everybody has the heart to sacrifice themselves.
每个人所看重的是神的家，而不是自己的益处。
Everyone.Focuses and emphasizes on the house of God and not our own
opinion.
Now we're going to consecrate the